Hola Mis Bonitas. So we're in the living room again just because lighting is better, and I am actually doing a collective haul. So I've been tracking, as I've always done, for how much I spend in a month, and this particular month I did so well with my low buy last month. I don't know what happened, but I went a little cuckoo with some things, and so I've kind of kept it all. I've been using some of the stuff, and I've also kind of wanted to share some things. So let me first show you the stuff that I actually purchased for a friend. Just because it kind of goes along. So I made a ColourPop order, and it was like the buy two lippies, get one free. They had that like limited edition, spend so much money, you get a product for free as well going on. And that's also when the Yes Please palette came into restock again. So I purchased two Yes Please palettes, and I actually ended up selling them. And then I picked up three lip colors. Two were for myself, and one I got for my friend. So the one that I got for my friend is the color LAX of the, what style is this? The Ultra Matte Lip. I also got the color Creeper for myself. And we'll see. It is, if I'm not mistaken, a very bright red. I thought it'd be really pretty to have. I had the Wet n Wild lip color, another brand that had a red lippy. I just don't really like it, so I want to try theirs out. I also have the color, which you'll be seeing, I believe, tomorrow when I upload. I'll actually be wearing it, but it's another lip color I also purchased from ColourPop. So then the stuff that these, oh, and then I also decided to try out their Rose Quartz. This is the crystal priming spray, so it's a setting spray. You can either use pre or to set your makeup. I just kind of thought it was neat. If you don't know already, I love stones and gems and all that jazz, and so I really liked Rose Quartz, and I just think it's really pretty. The packaging kind of sold me, so I want to try it out. I have other setting sprays. I'm currently working on panning one, and then I have another one. I finished up one, so this is just kind of my back stock. And these had come back into stock, so that's why I decided to get it, try it out. So then the products that were like part of the spend so much you get it for free, this was your actual, and two of these products never actually even tried before from ColourPop. So this was the Party of Five Super Shock Shadow. It was, like I said, that limited edition. I actually took this with me when I went on a trip recently. I use this as like to help for being like the base for my eyeshadows. So that is the color right there. It's very shimmery. I've used this all over the eye just kind of as like an actual eyeshadow, but then you really have to deepen the crease, and because there's so much glitter, it's one of those ones you really have to work and play with. The next one that I got for free also was the Super Shock Cheek, and this is in the color, I have no idea, I forget the colors. Actually, it's actually on the bottom. I use this a couple times. This is the color High Five. It's a pearlized version of it. It's actually really similar. It's so funny. It's actually really similar to the actual eyeshadow by them. So that is the blush right there. And this again is super like shimmery. I can see why people really like ColourPop because they're really soft and easy to apply. I use this more as like a blush topper when I did use it, but you have to make sure again, of course, that you really seal it up. So these are my two first like ColourPop actual Super Shock Cheek and eyeshadows, and these two are gonna be enough for me to work with for a bit. And the other color I've worn a couple times so far, this is the color 9 to 5 from the Ultra Glossy Lip. I think this is really pretty, and this is a great color, especially for fall, so it came out at a perfect time. So it has a metallic kind of like gold maroon sheen. It definitely goes with all those things that they actually gave out for free. So that was all that. Like I said, originally I had purchased two Yes Please palettes. I had the idea to do like a giveaway, and then it worked out to where it was easier just for me to sell them, unfortunately. So speaking of, I'm in a group on Facebook that you can sell used like brand new makeup or something that you've decluttered and it's still really good, like you maybe just swatched it or use it, and you can also do swaps actually on that group. So I swapped someone completely. Her and I paid our individual like shipping to ship it to the other person, and that was all that was required from the other. And so I actually ended up swapping the Urban Decay 50 anniversary palette that I've had for like years, and I ended up getting the Lorac Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales shadow, like eyeshadow palette. I actually don't own any Lorac palettes whatsoever. I just thought the packaging on this stuff was really neat. And the fact that she was the one that contacted me to swap me for my Urban Decay, I was just like, okay, sure. And it's completely brand new. I mean, there's the covering for, but none of the shadows have been used. The actual eyeliner has never been used. So I just thought this was awesome. And because I'm one of those people who likes to, like, I'm gonna have one thing, I'm gonna have the other. So because I got this pretty much for just paying for shipping, which was like $7, I kind of did a little bit of snooping and searching around. I used Poshmark, I was watching those groups, and I ended up finding the Pirates of the Caribbean, like, the cheek palette. And I haven't used it yet. They've kind of been sitting in my thing. I'm waiting for a time frame of where I feel just I have more time for makeup, because as you can see, it's super basic right now. But if you haven't already seen it, there's a cheek palette, and I just think it's super pretty and wonderful. And now I have the cheek palette to go inside of the eyeshadow palette. It's just giving myself the time to actually play with it. So again, for this one, I actually, with shipping and handling, I overall paid $20 for this one. I saw it was on sale at one point, actually, if I'm not mistaken, the Labor Day weekend, it was on sale at Kohl's, and I tried to order it because it was like $18, $15, $18, and I had a coupon, but by the time I ordered it to pick it up, all that jazz, they had actually sold out, so whatever works. Also from that group, I have been sitting on it, I've been researching, like, seeing, like, comparisons of, because the Subculture palette is this big, like, cult dislike right now, and I read a couple blogs for where they compare the color scheme in that to the Jeffree Star Androgyny palette that came out like months before the actual Subculture palette. So in that swap and makeup group, I actually found someone who was selling the Androgyny palette. This is my first actual, like, eyeshadow palette from Jeffree Star. I only have the lippies right now, and I'm okay with those, but I really want to try out his formula. And I like the Androgyny palette compared to the Beauty Killer palette. So this is that, if I'm not mistaken. I think they only swatch like two or three shadows. So you notice again that the colors are kind of similar to the Androgyny palette, sorry, to the Subculture palette. So I thought that'd be fun. I haven't decided if I am more into cool tones or to warm tones. I've been doing a lot of more neutrals and more color. So I'm hoping that with these particular two palettes, both the Androgyny and also the Pirates of the Caribbean by Lorac, that, like, it'll force me to go back into that, like, playing with color, but it being workable and wearable during the day. I don't know. We'll see. The last couple things, I went to Ross and I bought the brush cleaning pad because I thought these things are kind of awesome to use in between when I'm trying to change the color from my eyeshadows. I've used these and I've love them. There for, like, moisturizing underneath your eye, and I got this package for my friend. I also purchased, because I'm decluttering, a different product for my hair. This is from the Hair Chemist's coconut oil, so it's kind of helps spray in your hair to keep it nice and soft and manageable. And then I also bought a box of Patchology, their flash mask, those 5-minute ones. Great to use before putting on your makeup, so I probably will do this before I go to a wedding this weekend. But I got a box of these also from Ross. I will have it below listed. I did take the dive. Now, if you don't know, I love mineral eyeshadow. I have a ton of it. Like, eventually I plan on doing a more updated makeup collection. Have to organize it a little bit more, purge it a little bit more, maybe sell, swap, whatever. But I have Glamour Doll Eyes. They are the largest indie brand that I have in my collection. I've actually purged it and sold some colors, quite a bit actually, to people who collect them, because there is this whole underground Glamour Doll Eyes vibe and group that they collect them. I've had them for quite a bit since I first got onto YouTube and found them, so that was about 2010. Around 2010, 2011 is when I started collecting them. I stopped collecting them about 2014, so it's a good 3 years. I pretty much got a lot of the colors, a lot of collections. So I decided to take the plunge when they were doing, like, the teasers for the Halloween collection that came out. So I got the whole little collection from them. For there was two different ones. I got this one. This one has the color Flatline, Magical Brew, which is a really pretty green. Flatline kind of looks like a beige with a little gray undertone. Immorality, which is a beautiful shimmer. And then Violet Pose, which is like a purple. So I haven't even touched them. They're full jars, sealed, all that jazz. So information for Glamour Delights will be linked below. But I haven't actually purchased from them in a really long time. So by doing so, I was kind of decided it was time to revisit a very favorite brand of mine. The last bit is a purchase that I made to Sephora right towards the tail end of this month. Because I've been watching the reviews of the Too Faced Peach Perfect Comfort Matte Foundation. I really have been enjoying now the more natural look. Today I actually have on just powder foundation and some cream contour, highlight, all that jazz. And it's kind of worn interesting. But for the days that I want just a little more coverage, I'm trying this one out, or will. This is in the color light beige, so I'm not quite certain if it's the right color. I'll have to find out. But I purchased this, as well as I decided to do the Tarte Skincare High Performance Natural. So it was like a little package. It was for $12. Inside of it has the Tarte 4-in-1 Lights Camera Lashes, the mini mascara. It also has a pack of their eye patches, which I'm really excited to try this out. And then also has their, and I think the reason why I originally put this slide was because of this. I wanted to try their Mercutia C Brightener Eye Treatment. So it's like a mini jar of this. And this was for $12, so I thought it was a pretty good deal. I'm so about this mascara. Really looking forward to using this and also the eye patches to kind of see. I had a $100 perk and I decided to use it on another Tarte product. This is the Tarte Drink of H2O, drink of water. It's their moisturizer. So I just recently used the Rainforest of the Sea face cleanser. I kind of liked it. But since I have other products I want to push through, I'm not going to necessarily buy that right away. But I thought it'd be fun to try out some more skincare from Tarte. So I turned in my 100 points for that. I also decided to get the, I chose to get the little mini primer from Too Faced, the Cooling Matte Perfecting Primer. From what I've been watching of reviews, the actual foundation is water-based, and I don't have a water-based foundation primer, like face primer, so I thought this would be great to have to go coincide with this. The other option from online that I've watched also from Too Faced, it is the Hangover RX face primer. It's also good if you're looking for more water-based foundations. And then my samples from that order, the NARS Creamy Radiance, the Boscia Cleansing Gel, and then the Lancome Revigier Eye Correcting Cream. So that is it for the products that I've recently made purchases for. I'm going to put back my stuff for my friend in the box that it belongs to. But questions, comments, concerns, let me know below. I might do a first impressions on this. I'm not quite certain. It just depends on if I have some daylight, daytime. My filming's been a little bit off as of recent, and I plan to get back more to it on schedule with the coming October. You can see my red is nice and bright. I just redid my hair recently, so, that is it for me. Questions, comments, concerns, let me know. Until next time, guys, I'll be talking to you very soon. Besos. Bye.